what got you into painting?
I've done art since I was in kindergarten, if not before. So I've just always been involved in art, and I was kind of one of those kids who always, you know, was always. I do oil primarily because.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Primarily.
I mean, but I also do a lot of watercolor. But
do you like oils the best? Is that
yeah?
Why?
I,
okay.
They're a lot more forgiving than watercolors are.
Mm-hmm.
But probably for pure painting, watercolors is the most exciting. Yeah. Water wants to water wants to move around the paper. So. And you really have to master techniques with watercolor. And pretty much oil, you just put the paint on. You know, you just if you can paint a bathroom wall, you can apply oil paint to a canvas. Yeah. Just have to learn how to draw and mix colors. Yeah. But watercolor is just really unpredictable.
Well,
yeah, I really love landscapes. And then every now and then I go off on tangents and we'll do old trucks, or I'll do old gas stations.
Mm-hmm.
I did a whole series of food paintings. Since I have a window coming up in the gallery, I'm going to do all Skull Valley paintings.
Oh.
So I'm going to do it down there. I've already done a lot of Skull Valley out here, but in the Southwest than anywhere else. In the Midwest, it's all the same color green. The bushes are the same, probably back east. The bushes are the same. The only break in that is pine trees or spruces. But the grass is the same color as the trees, the same color as the bushes. So out here, you probably have 50 different colors of green. That's just wonderful. And then we have the sky, this great light that's just amazing. And Chicago tends to be gray most of the time.
Each of people out, sailboats and rocks. Well, there's Lake Powell and you have people on the beach. And so I always sit on the beach and I paint.
Mm.
Sunset, so these are
paints and a little board and paper all cut up, so I'm ready to go in a minute. I got all my. So. And that's what's so nice about watercolors is that they're so portable, and they're not really toxic, unless of course you eat them. But I've got my little sets of watercolors and my color chart, so I always can paint. So I go out to Chicago and I paint, and I'm just always ready to go at a moment's notice. So I do a drawing in chalk, and then I paint on an acrylic. But I always like the red or the deep purple, which is like this. This one needs another coat, but I always paint on those because the colors really pop out, and then you don't get little specks of red. So I do a drawing in chalk, and then I do it and I usually start with the sky. I did paint in the sky in this one first because I think the sky sets the light. So then I have all my colors out, I did the sky, and then I came down to the ground because I felt the road, I wanted to get the shadows in. Mm-hmm. And so this, I do like a light wash of color in oil, and then I come back in and build up color. So this one is still in that process. I've got to do the lighter clumps of leaves and reactivate the color. And now all my brushes set up, and I fortunately have acquired great old office furniture and tabourets over the years. I've got all my colors here, and I've got my watercolors here. And so it's a real nice place to work. I've held every office
and is held
every
okay.
office and committee chair except QC. It's such a great way to sell your work, and you get to meet people and tell them about your work, and plus it's just we all really pull our own weight in there. We all really it's just a great way to work. It's because you're inspired by the other artists, you know, the amount of freedom you get in that gallery is amazing. You know, once you're juried in, how you arrange your wall, what work you don't, you know, I've been in a lot of other galleries, and they're always telling you, well, bring in more of this, bring in more of that, and you go in to see your work, and it's in the back room because, well, we didn't need it out right now. Mm. But this is, it's just been such a great experience. And the fact that we're still in business and a viable member of the community in our 18th year now has just been wonderful. And like with any human organization, we've had our, you know, we've had our conflicts, but somehow that co-op always takes care of itself. And I think the criteria we have for, you know, plays well with others is really important, especially in a co-op.
Sweet sound.